day to you. That is an interesting smell. Do not know what these are, but obviously something is eating on them. And there's no dead animals around, so pretty safe assumption that they're not poisonous. It's another thing. There's no such thing as poison. It's all relative. There's strength, potency. Makes a little green on the bottom. Take some from the top. Boom. Tastes pretty decent. So if you want to see if something out in nature is poisonous. No, not poisonous. If you want to see if it's going to have a strong reaction, you hold it in your mouth. You don't swallow it. You hold it in your mouth for a little while. And the time period is going to depend upon the person and the substance. Give it about 5 minutes, anywhere from 5 to 15 minutes, and you're going to feel, and a lot of times it'll be instantaneous, you'll feel the agitation, and it'll let you know pretty quickly, hey, your body may have a strong reaction to this. Then go ahead and spit it out, don't swallow. With this, it tasted very pleasant. I don't know, and I'm not recommending people go out and just eat random mushrooms. But this is a relatively safe way to see if something's going to have a strong reaction for your system. I don't know, something's coming to mind like bolete or some kind of mushroom like that. It's very similar. I don't think that's what it is. It has a pleasant taste. Not very mushroomy. It's pretty pleasant though. I did go ahead and swallow it, so I'll be recording it if I'm flopping around an English layer. Which won't happen. But if it does, it'll be entertaining. Nature's carpet. Oh man, that feels nice. What are those? Oh man. Those mushrooms kind of made my tongue tingle a little bit, so I went ahead and spit those out. Probably would have been just fine, but I'd rather not have an upset stomach right now, so. White fungus on it. Fungus on the fungus. Dandelion greens. Pretty much everywhere. Fairly nutritious. It's good for cleansing. It's good for the liver. It's a diuretic. More so the roots. It's plantain. Very abundant in silica. Also edible. And the tastes are always going to vary. upon the season, upon the soil, upon the age. You can tell you're getting like that one. It has like a, it's hard to describe, like a milky quality about it. It feels very nourishing. And I mean, as you can probably not see, but both of those are pretty much everywhere. Planting leaf. It's a little bit bitter. Plantain is also really wonderful to make little poultices out of. If you have a scrape, get an injury out in the nature, chew one of those up, smack it right on that scrape or wound, and it's a great assistant in the healing process. I've used it many times. Definitely seems to aid in the process. A lot of nature is more edible than what we've been led to believe. I would definitely recommend the people to research their local, look up local wild edibles, but I mean, you'll be very amazed at just how much is actually edible and how much you can use. I mean, this is part of the purpose of this creation, is that we use this. This was created for us, not so that we live in houses, live in boxes, live isolated from it. We're never supposed to be separated from it. Part of the trick, part of the illusion of separation. So yeah, get your souls on the soil, ground yourself, get out in nature, breathe some fresh air, some fresh pollens, which will not give you an allergic reaction unless you are severely clogged up if your lymph system is not functioning properly, not excreting the way it should be, if you're not sweating all that much. That's one of the most important things, is utilize your body's natural mechanisms, natural processes. Begin the process of becoming aware of your processes. This is part of remembering, part of waking up, realizing what's always been right there. Right at your fingertips. So just waiting on you.